go down to our first guest in our post-game show. Also with two goals here today as well, the Fogo, Vinny Fascipanti, joining us. Vinny, like I had to say to Jim, if a face-off guy scores two goals, we got to talk to him. Run us through both of those, what you saw winning those face-offs clean.
Basically, I can play offense as well for the most part, I think so. So when I get that opportunity and I see, a lane like that to go to the goal, I'm able to do it. So I just kind of just go by what I do in practice, all the shooting skills, look for also like in pregame and everything, all those types of shots, and just let it go sometimes.
You're having a good season so far at the X as the season has worn its way on. How have you found what are the things that have been making you so successful this season?
Honestly, I got to put in a lot to my wings. My wings have done a lot for me, because they helped me with the battle. A lot of those faceoffs I wouldn't even have won if it wasn't for my wings going in there, letting me get the ground balls or even them getting the ground balls. So I got to put all my pressure on the wings too. They've done an amazing job this year, and so is this whole team.
And Coach Chow has rotated a couple other face-off guys and wing players in today. How valuable is that time for all those guys?
Oh, it's so valuable because, technically I'm the only face-off guy on the roster. So getting Connor reps and also Bruno reps and Brett reps and Tyler reps, it's just huge. It just shows that we have depth at every position on this team. So I think that was huge.
And speaking of depth, you guys went three goalies deep today. Talk about what you saw out of those guys.
Yeah, all three of our goalies are studs. I'll take any three of our goalies to war any day. I think they're awesome. I think Jack's a stud. I think Ian's a stud. And I also think Jack's a stud as well. But the other Jack, all three of them are awesome. It was a great game today. We just got to keep pushing forward.
I don't know if Coach would like to hear this, but I love seeing you get the green light and going down and shoot. So, keep winning faceoffs and keep shooting early and often.
Got it. Thank you.
You're a stud.
Thank you. Thank
You're
you.
A stud.
And he's going to go pass that microphone off to Gunnar Reynolds, who will get him set up here in just a minute. And of course, Gunnar Reynolds making his season debut here today. And Gunnar, just really, knowing that you're going to get to play today pregame, what were your emotions like out on the field warming up today?
I would say it's just, it's nothing new. I've been here before, so I was just kind of take it as, just going off the, trying to get off on the same foot as I left off on last year. Trying to worry about the injuries less and less, trying to put that behind me. So, I was just focused, got my music going, all the boys were riled up. So, I was just really excited.
Your first action since last year and be able to get out there, and it looked like you were trying to, take someone's head off with a couple of those shots. How did it feel to be able to grip it and rip it a couple times today?
It felt great, man. I was just trying to get some rust off. The goalie made a couple, big saves on me. So, I'm a little ticked off about that, but I'm just getting some rust off, so that's all.
And of course, you hope this is going to be getting some more game time, and as we move forward, what's been the biggest key to your rehab and your success to come back out on the field?
Sean Farmer, he is the GOAT. He's my athletic trainer, and he's been like my best friend for like the past 8 months. He's doing everything he can with me off the field. He makes so many sacrifices for this team and for this school. And, that will never go underappreciated with me. And, Sean's just a man, and he's helped me get through a lot of, he's fed me confidence. He's been so hard on me. He actually does a lot of the rehab stuff with me. So, we kind of help each other out and get back in shape, trying to lay off the sodas.
And, of course, you've been acting as another coach from the sideline. Talk about what that experience has been like through the first, batch of games.
Yeah, well, Coach, let me run the box. So, at first, it was a little nerve-wracking. I didn't know what I was doing. But, once I kind of, growed, passionate about it, and I just started really trying hard at it, and it was kind of awesome. It was a cool experience. It's not like I wouldn't do that anyway. Like, I'm usually, a very vocal person on the sidelines, so I'm yelling in the game trying to coach anyways. So, I got the platform to do it, not in a uniform. So, nothing really changed there, but other than just running the box.
Well, Gunnar, it was a pleasure to see you back in uniform and back out on the field today. A great win today, and good luck the rest of the way. Go ahead, and we'll get over to Coach Childs there in just a moment. So thanks a lot, Gunnar. It was good seeing you out there.
No problem. Shout out to all my teammates.
So, of course, Gunnar Reynolds. And if you – I mentioned in the broadcast last week, if you missed it, I really suggest you check out the York Daily Record with their article on Gunnar. Fantastic article. So make sure you go out there and check it out if you haven't already. Coach, a big 15-3 win out there. And, of course, what was it like to see Gunnar back out for the first time this season?
I mean, obviously, we were all happy to get him out there, and he's worked really hard to come back, and just thrilled to give him the opportunity to play. It's been a long, long time coming.
You're able to work in all three goalies here today. Talk about the value of the game time for those three.
Yeah, I mean, it might be our deepest position. If you watch us practice, I don't think you'd be able to tell who the starter is. I mean, we're all three of them are fantastic and playing really well, and it's awesome to be able to get them all in the game and not have any kind of drop-off in terms of the performance. So,
and what your thoughts on just the overall performance of the team today?
Yeah, I mean, first and foremost, I really liked Lebanon Valley. I thought number 5 and number 12 for them just did so much. 5 took so many faceoffs and then stayed on and played defense, and then 12 was on the wing of every faceoff and then stayed on and played offense. So my hat goes out to those guys. I thought they just played so hard, and so that's the first thing that I would say is I was really impressed with Lebanon Valley and how hard they played. As far as for us, I thought we did a good job of you know, I think in years past, in the beginning of in the first quarter, we took a ton of shots and the goalie made a lot of saves, and I think in the past that would have rattled us, but we just stayed the course and chipped away and got some to drop there, and so I'm proud of our guys for just kind of staying poised and staying composed and weathering out some of the hot goalie play in the beginning.
The team as a whole was pretty hot from the faceoff X. What did you see out of all the guys that you threw out there today?
Yeah, I mean, that's another thing. It was cool to be able to get some different guys facing off. Obviously, Vinny, you know, did well in the first half for us and put a couple in the goal, too. And but then, you know, using Connor and Ray there and giving us some depth there, which was it's good to be able to get those guys in and again, see them succeed and do well.
And now a little bit of time off until your next game against Hood. And what, you know, when you end up with some of these longer times, what do you do to try to simulate game time throughout the course of a long week?
Yeah, well, we started getting a little bit more competitive in practice, keeping score and kind of evaluating, not necessarily the score, but efficiency. So we're using the Division I offensive efficiencies and defensive efficiency numbers that are online as kind of our barometer of evaluating our possessions and kind of turning a good percentage of those into stops or goals, depending upon which end. And so we did a little bit of research to figure out like what an ideal number is, and then communicate it with the guys and then get them to battle one another to try to hit that efficiency mark. And so less about one team having more goals than the other, but more about the percentage of execution on the two ends. And so we implemented that this week, and I thought it definitely created a higher intensity and I guess just a better urgency and focus in practice. And so we'll probably pick up right there where we left off on Monday, you know, try to become as good as we can in time for May.
Well, Coach, congratulations on the win, and we look forward to catching up with you again on April 20th against Hood.
All right, thanks a lot, guys. Thanks for all you do.
Thank you very much. That's Coach Brandon Childs joining us there for our postgame show. Is York with the win, 15-3 over Lebanon Valley, and again, as they now improve to 9-0 on the season, 4-0 in the MAC, and we'll be back in about 10 days for that game. For Jim Murphy, I'm Jared Welsh. We'll see you next time on the Spartan Game Day Network.